So I was fascinated by your take the other day. I know, you know, you and I have had conversations on Chasing News and here about President Trump and you know, what happens when a foreign dictator crosses a line. But you had an interesting take on this latest attack, and I wanted you to share it with our audience.
Thanks, Bill. Well, we've been at war for 7 years. About 500,000 people lost their lives. We're tired, frustrated, exhausted. And when the president, who I supported all the way, except until this last one, and I did not support him bombing Syria, he said because of our vital American interest. We have no vital American interest in Syria. If, you know, to poke someone in the eye and stand back, have friction with Russia, and then the terrorists who are looking to do us harm, they are now standing back and they're smiling and they're laughing at what happened. So there's no vital American interest there. What it should be sitting at the table and trying for peace.
How do you think you solve it, Michael? I mean, you've got, like, for example, we talked about now they've allowed inspectors to go into where this chemical attack was happened, at least according to our intelligence. And, you know, there's been some confusion on who was really responsible, right, for that attack. You know, was this the terrorist? Was it Assad? And, you know, is it the question of that has made you doubt this, or do you think it was disruptive? Like, you supported the missile attack that hit the airbase a year ago, I thought.
It did, yeah. There was a reason for it. But this one, there's no absolute reason for this. We don't know who started the attack. We know that the terrorists also have access to the chemical weapons.
Right.
We don't know for sure who did this. And as far as how you solve this, Bill, Russia and China has big influence on Syria. They're the ones we should be talking to, and the Syrians, and say, let's have peace. Enough is enough of this.
Yeah. How do you get to peace without at least flexing some muscle, though? I mean, I think that, you know, it's not like you can have a conversation with the terrorists.
Yeah, Bill, when you're strong, we don't have to prove how strong we are. People know how strong. They know our might. They know, you know, the force of our military. Mm-hmm. We don't have to prove how strong we are. We are strong. The world knows that. We don't have to, like I said, poke him in the eye and then stand back. What do you think is going to happen? Now we have more haters because of that.
So how do you, are you getting calls from people locally? Are you hearing from Syrians who have come here and gotten to the country over the past 10 years or so? And is there this concern about their families?
A big concern. As a matter of fact, the patriarch of our church worldwide issued a statement against what happened, just because now it puts more stress on the minorities and even the Muslims too, because now the terrorists are emboldened and they say, well, look at this, the United States is actually supporting us. That's how this looks to them.
It's amazing. Because we're taking such a hard line against Assad?
It's very complicated, Bill. In Syria and in the Middle East, there are multiple religions, there are multiple sects within your religion, there are different tribes. There are tribes who have their own sovereign property that the government does not control. Very complicated. We can't just go in and say, let's bomb them and things will be okay.
I'll tell you this, Michael. I agree with you on that. I was actually, my producer, Kristen, and I were just talking about this as far as the George W. Bush intervention in the Middle East and, you know, taking out Hussein, which effectively destabilized the area. And I wonder, and let me ask you, if Assad is taken out, do you think that it could be premature, that you'd have ISIS overrunning the country? Will it make it less stable than it is today? And it's pretty bad right now.
Yeah, the lesson learned from Libya and from Iraq and from Yemen is we can't take the president and his government and not have a follow-up plan. We don't have a follow-up plan.
We don't
have a strategy.
No, we don't. There's no comprehensive strategy. What's the next step? And I don't know that we've got the appetite, nor should we, for nation building.
We have enough, you know, like trouble in the United States to worry about. We don't have to go over there and try to solve their problems. You know, we'll never have democracy in the Middle East because of all the different religions and the sects and the tribes. And really, really complicated. You know, people have to live there to really understand how complicated that is.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you, it's a conversation that's going to continue. I really appreciate your different perspective on this, and I wanted to share that with the audience. So thank you for joining me this morning. You and I will definitely be in touch. We're going to have you back on both shows in the near future.